about it. So we're a Mem Zayin Amud Aleph. And we said that, so Amar Rav Yosef, Nekot Rav Yochanan B'yadcha, that we sit in the sukkah, but we don't make a block. Dravuna bar on Shmini Atzeres. Dravuna bar Bizna v'chol G'doyli Ador, Iklu B'sukkah B'Shmini Sofek Shvi. Dravuna and all the G'doylim were in the sukkah on this eighth day. Mesav Ava Yosri, but Bruchi lo Barichi. They sat in the sukkah, but they didn't make a bracha. Freik the Gemara, but that's not right. V'dil Mesvir lu Kamadom or Kivin Shabir Chiyon Tavish and Shuvena Mavarech. Maybe he was of the opinion, which we had an opinion, that once someone makes a leishet basuk on the first day, you never have to make it again. And maybe the reason they didn't make a bracha on Shmini Atzeres is because they relied on the bracha that they made on the first day of Sukkot. So the Gemara answers, Gemiri de ma'afer otsu. Because they had not been at home all week. They had been in the field. And they had not, so they really had not made a bracha for sukkah at all. So the fact that they sat in the sukkah and didn't make a bracha on Shmini Atzeres is a raya that you don't make a bracha. That's how this version of the Gemara ends. Ikki d'amri. Other people learned the discussion went like this. Bruchi, regarding the bracha, kulam aloi pligi de lo mevarchima. There's no machloikes that you don't make a bracha. In fact, ki pligi lemesiv. There's a mandarma that holds you don't even sit in the sukkah on the shmini. Right? Lemandarma shiva lo sukkah mesiv yasvinan. The one who said that because it's a sofik shvi, you have to sit. Ulemandarma shmini lezelozeh mesiv namid leyasvinan. Not only do you not make a bracha, you don't sit in the sukkah. Omrav Yosef Nekot Rab Yoichnan Biyadcha. You should take what Rab Yoichnan said, the Mordesh Maitzimani. He's sort of the master of halacha. That Rav Yudah Breid Rav Shmuel Bar Shilas Vashmi Sofik Shvi Levar Misukkah Yosef. He sat outside of the sukkah on Shmini. But V'ilchus Amesav Yasvin and Bruch Lom Rachinon. This is the famous Maskon of the Gemara regarding Shmini Atzeres, that we do sit, but we don't make a bracha. And that's pretty much out the Welt Firtzach. The Shulchan Aruch says, regarding the mitzvah of Sukkah on Shmini Atzeres, I'll read the Shulchan Aruch. B'chutz la'aretz oichlin b'sukkah b'shmini atzeres mishum sofik yom shvi. So he says very clearly, you sit and you eat in the sukkah on Shmini Atzeres because it's a sofik yom shvi. Hain balayla v'hain bayom, both at night and in the day. Aval ein mevarchim leishev b'sukkah. You don't make the bracha. Umaskirin b'kiddush uvetfilah Shmini Atzeres for shechianu. In kiddush and in the davening, you say Shmini Chag Atzeres Hazeh, and you say a Shechianu by Kid.
My meaning is to, like you said, the Hasidim. You know, we go down, don't eat at night. We make Kiddush, go down, make Kiddush, and then Fazer gets it from the sukkah, and that's it.
Yeah, but it's Shulchan Aruch, but doesn't pass.
I'm reading the Shulchan. Yeah, I think
Shulchan Aruch Paskins the different way. I don't understand where the Hasidim got this from.
The Hasidim. Yeah. They make kiddush in the sukkah, and that's how they potter. That both night and day, that's how they potter this din that they made kiddush in the sukkah. But
I've seen them. Some of them make kiddush just at night. In the day, they don't go in the sukkah.
Well, I'm going to continue reading. V'rova poskim poskul alocha kimaskonis agemora bezeh. Most of the poskim paskin like the maskona we just learned. Achein Ravu Mo'od Shitas Aposkim Beprote Advarim. The Rabu Aminagim, it became, there are many Minagim. Shayu Shalo Achlu Besukkah Achila Gemura. Some didn't eat a full meal in the Sukkah. O she'achlu mechtzi suda. They ate half of the meal. O she'achlu rak b'yom v'lo b'layla. Some minig was to eat in the daytime, but not the night. Okay, so you see there was ravu minogim. Interesting, Johnny said their minig was to eat in the night and not in the day. It looks like there was a more common minig where they ate in the day and not at night. Okay. Well, the inyan shena besukka beyond the kotzlu rabbi min aposkim, shein lishon besukka. So the maril, even the Ashkenazim, don't sleep in the sukkah. Even though if it's suffek shvi, you know, why aren't they sleeping in the sukkah? You're supposed to sleep in the sukkah on shvi shel Pesach. V'chein ha-minig parshut. See the Be'er Heitev, the Mishnah Bura, that the halach is we don't sleep in the sukkah shmina tzeret. V'lomaisa rabu ha-minogim b'chol eila, v'chol mokom ha-beis av no'egim k'minogam. It's exactly what Johnny, each family does like their minig. And that's it. To be honest with you, before I moved to Young Israel of Hancock Park, you know, Rabbi Krauss feared himself very much in the Yeshiva Shederach. But I remember in the home as well, we also didn't eat in the sukkah of Shmini Atzeres. We were Belzer Hasidim. And I don't remember that we made Kiddush at night. I don't think we did anything at all in the daytime. Similar to Johnny.
But then, no, I make Kiddush in the daytime. I don't go in at night.
Okay, that's like what I brought tonight. Anyways.
Yeah. You go in Shmini Atzeres, Arab Shmini Atzeres at night, or you don't go, only the daytime?
I go only the daytime. I go like down this. And make Kiddush.
Yeah. I'm saying, Harold, yeah. I think this was Armin Hagim. When I moved to Young Israel of Hancock Park, and you know, Rabbi Krauss would say that the Minigai Yeshivas was this approach. So we also adopted that approach. It was a change for us because we had not eaten in the sukkah Shmini Atzeres. I don't know, Walter right. was in South Africa. That was more of an Ashkenazi place. There wasn't a lot of Hasidim. I bet you it was more makpid in the sukkah there. What did Rabbi Bronner do in South Africa?
Yeah, you ate. Well, Rabbi Bronner was from the Hasidim.
So he didn't eat.
Your mother-in-law too.
Made Kiddush on Friday.
And then they went inside.
And I'm not sure if they made Kiddush the next day there either. I'm not sure. I don't remember.
But it's clearly changed. You know, the Rabbi Krauss taught us more the yeshivish way. And certainly in the yeshivas, this is how they did it.
No, because that's a Litvish minhag.
Because the Shulchan Aruch says, we just read the Shulchan Aruch. You know, Shulchan Aruch says very clearly that you eat both days in the sukkah. So it's interesting that times changed.
Well, Chabadniks also eat the Shmini Atzeres in the sukkah.
Okay.
Well, the Chabad came from that part of the world.
Yeah, but at least we learned the Gemara very thoroughly. We see the Maskana, we see how the Shulchan Aruch Paskin, and we see also that the Shulchan Aruch mentions that there's a lot of minhagim. And the Mishnah Berurah says that each one does according to his base of. Okay. Om Rav Yechna. We move to another topic. Shechianu. Oimrim Zman B'Shmini Shulchat. So for example, gentlemen, on the seventh day of Pesach, when we make Kiddush, we don't make Shechianu. Shvi'i Shel Pesach is not its own Yom Tov. Since we made Kiddush the first day of Pesach, we said Shechianu. We don't make Shechianu again on the Shvi'i Shel Pesach. Come Shmini Atzeres, the Gemara says, we do make a new Shechianu on Shmini Atzeres. And ve'ein oimrim zman the Shvi'i Shel Pesach. We don't say Shechianu, even though we had Chol HaMoed, and now we're going to celebrate another Yom Tov. There's no Shechianu on the seventh day. They're different in three ways. The sukkah, the lulav, the nisuch hamayim. Meaning, Shmini Atzeres is different than the first 7 days of sukkahs because you don't sit in the sukkah, you don't shake the lulav, and there was no Nisach HaMayim. That was all done with. There was no Nisach HaMayim on Shmini Atzeres. Rabbi Yehuda, the Omer Belugai Menasech Kol Shmona, Rabbi Yehuda was of the opinion that you did do Nisach HaMayim on Shmini Atzeres as well. So Harei Cholik B'Shnei Dvar. Well, Shmini Atzeres still has two differential points. The fact that you don't eat in the sukkah and you don't shake the lulav. Well, Shvi Shel Pesach is different than the first day of Pesach, where there is no chiyuv to eat matzah on the seventh day. There's only chiyuv matzah to eat matzah in a Torah the first night of Pesach. So you could say, well, Shvi Shel Pesach is different than the first day of Pesach in that there's no chiyuv matzah. There's a reshus to eat matzah, but there's no chiyuv. The Omar Mar, Laila Rishoyna, Choyva, Ikan Ve'elech Rishus. After the first night of Pesach, there's no, if you don't want to eat bread, i.e. matzah, for the next 7 days of Pesach, you don't have to eat bread, even in the next day. The Chiyuv eating matzah only one night. So the Gemara wanted to say, maybe that's enough to differentiate Shvi Shel Pesach, that it should get its own Shechiyan. Versus Achiyasha, there's no comparison. Hosam mi laila chaluk mi yom ein chaluk. It's not different. For example, the first day of Pesach. Also, you don't have a chi of matzah. So it's not different than the Shvi Shel Pesach. Hachafil mi yom nami chaluk. But Shmini Shel Atzeres is different compared to the other days of Sukkot in the day as well, not just the night. In that we don't sit in the Sukkot, we don't shake the lulav. Ravina Amar Zecholuk Mishalafonov, Zecholuk Mishalafonov. Shmini Atzeres is different from the day before, but Shvi Shel Pesach is only different from the first day of Pesach, like, you know, 6 days before it. So it's not enough of a differential. Amar Rav Papa, another reason. Hacha Ksiv Par. Shmini Atzeres, the Musaf is only one par. And Hosam Ksiv Parim. The other days, right, we start with 13, we go down to 7. So there's Parim. So that's what differentiates Shmini Atzeres from the other days of Sukkot. From that, by Yitzhak Amar Hacha Ksiv Bayom. It says Bayom HaShmini. And by the other days, it says Uvayom. That's his reasoning for why Shmini Atzeres gets a different zman. Rav Ashi Amar Hacha Ksiv Kamishpat, Hacha Ksiv Kamishpatam. By Shmini Atzeres it says Kamishpat. Min Chatam Nizkem Lapar La'ayav Lakvasim Mimisparam Kamishpat. And by the other days of Sukkot it says Min Chasam Nizkem Lapar La'ayav Lakvasim Mimisparam Kamishpatam. To teach us that all the 7 days of Sukkot are connected together, separate from Shmini Atzeres. Lema Messiah Lay, let us say that the following Memra is support what we're saying. Aparim ha'elim bakvasim, ma'akvin zed zed. That on the various days of Sukkot, when you have to bring a par, an aisle, and a keves, they're all considered one korban, and therefore if you miss any of them, the par, the aisle, the kvasim, they're ma'akev the whole thing. Rav Yehuda Omer, Purim ein ma'akvin zetzeh. That the Purim are not ma'akev. Because we go down anyways in the numbers. On the first day, you bring 14. And then we go down until 7. So you see, there's no reason to be ma'akev if you don't bring one of the Purim. Amru lo, they responded to Rav Yehuda. What do you mean? Valo kulam ismatin v'ochim b'shmini. Yeah, but every one of the korbanos dropped down on Shmini because it's only one. So Amarlen Shmini regel b'fnei atzmahu. You can't bring a rye from there because Ein Hachanami Shmini Atzeres is a yontif by itself, which is not connected to the Shivas Yimei HaSukkos. Shekeshem sheshivas Yimei HaChag to unin korban shir bracha v'lina. The 7 days of Sukkos requires its own korban. It gets its own shear. It has its own bracha. We'll see what that bracha is. And lina, that there's a din that you have to sleep the night after that day in Yerushalayim. Av shmini ton korban shir bracha v'lina. Shmini atzeres requires the same halachas. Now, what does it mean when we say that Shmini Atzeres gets its own bracha? Zman? Does it refer to Shechiyanu and this is a raya? Lo. Birkas Amoznu Tefillah. We're talking about that we're maskir Shmini Atzeres in benching and Tefillah, we say Yom Chag Shmini Atzeres as it. We don't say Chag HaSukkos as it. And that makes logical sense. The Isak Adaitich Zman, because if we're talking about that Shmini Atzeres and the days of Sukkot are different, and the bracha we're talking about is Shechianu, Zman Kol Shiva Mi'ika, there is no Shechianu said every day of the 7 days of Sukkot, say on the first day. So the Gemara says, that's not a kasha, haloi kasha. So for example, let's say you forgot to say Shechiyah on the first day of Sikkos. You know what? You could say it on the second day. And if you forgot on the second day, you could say it on the third day. Oli Yom Achmina. Freit de Gemara, fine. You might be able to say it. But mikol makom kos be'inon. Yeah, but when are you going to say the Shechiyah? You need to do it a la kos. And there is no kos on the other days of Yontif. You don't have a kos all the time. Are you telling me Lema Mesaila Rav Nachman? Are you telling me this Gemara is like Rav Nachman, Dar Rav Nachman, Zamoim Rafilu Bashuk? It's a machlokes. Whether or not Shechiyanu can just be said anywhere, or whether it always has to be established with a kos. Well, the fact that you advance the idea that on the 7 days of Sukkot, you could say Shechiyanu no matter what, even if you didn't have a kos. Are we holding like Rav Nachman that you can say Shechiyanu even in the Shuk? The Iyamit being in kos, kos kol yomei b'yika. Because if you're going to tell me you need a kos, well, we don't have a kos every day of the 7 days of Yom. Versus Domediklali kos. That's not a kasha, because maybe he had a kos. And then he could say Shechiyanu. Okay. Sover Rav Yuna Shmini Ton Lina. Now, we said before that even Shmini Atzeres requires this special din that you have to sleep in Yerushalayim the night after the Yontif. Is that true for Shmini Atzeres? Vatanya. Rav Yudoyne. Minay lePesach Sheni Shenaton Lina. Pesach Sheni does not require you to stay in Yerushalayim that night. Shenamar Fanisa Baboker Valachta Laolecha. Uksiv Sheishes Amim Toichal Matzois. So Eshaton Shisha. The kind of Pesach that requires 6 days, which is regular Pesach, that Yontif needs Lina. Eshenaton Shisha Enaton Lina. But Pesach Sheni, that's not 6 days, only 1 day, that does not need Lina. And what else is it coming to exclude? Lumutemai. Lav Lumutin Nami Shmini Shel Chag. That perhaps Shmini Shel Chag also doesn't have a din of Lina. Lo, Lumutin Pesach Sheni, the Kavose. It's mamish to come to my Pesach Sheni. Chanami Mistavrit, it's none. Habikurim, when Klai Yisrael brought Bikurim, the Beis HaMikdash, to Unin Korbin, you brought a Korbin, like a Korbin Shlomim with the Bikurim. Vishir, it had a special Shir. Utnufa, you had to wave the Bikurim. Velina, and there's a din of Lina. Now, Man Shamas Leidomer Tnufa. Who's, hi Saul. Sid. Man Shamas Leidomer Tnufa. Who's the Mandomer that holds that you have to wave the Bikurim of Yuda? Vika Omer Ton Lina. And he claims that it requires Lina as well. Where do we see that? Titania, Ruda Oimer. Vihinachto, referring to the Bikurim, Zutnufa. You have to wave it. Maybe it means just placing it. Because Kishu Omer Vihi Nicho, you already said place it. Arianach Omer, Amani Makai Vinachto, Zutnufa. I Vidim Rabbi Ezra Ben Yaakov, maybe it's not Rabbi Yehuda. Maybe it's another Mandom, Rabbi Ezra Ben Yaakov, the Tanya, the Lokach HaKoin HaTenem Yadech, the coin shall take the basket from your hand. Limeid Ala Bikurim Shetu Unin Tnufa, the Rabbi Ezra Ben Yaakov. So it's not just Rabbi Yehuda who connects it with Lina. Maybe it's Rabbi Ezra Ben Yaakov that holds that Bikurim requires Tnufa. And my time, Rabbi Ezra Ben Yaakov, Asya Yad Yad Mishlomim. He learns a Hekesh from, it says V'lokacha koin atene miyodecha, from your hand. And by Shlomim, it says, Yado tiviena es ishe Hashem. So just like a Shlomim needs tnufa, Bikurim needs tnufa. Ma'akan koye, af alen koin, and you need a koye. Mal alen balim, the owners have to be part of the tnufa of kan balim. Now, how do both the koin and the balim, the owners of these korbonos, do the tnufa? Ha'ketzat. Kohen meiniach yadu tachas yad bailim umeiniv. That means the bailim hold it. The kohanim put their hands underneath the hands of the bailim umeiniv. So the Gemara now says, my havialo. What is this din regarding shechiano on shmini atzeres? Rav Nachman Omar, oimrim zman b'shmini shulcha. You do say shechiano. Rav Sheshes Omar, ein oimrim zman b'shmini shulcha. You don't say Shechianu. The Hilchasa Oimrim Zman B'Shmini Shulchan. You do say Tanya Kavos Rav Nachman. There's a Brisa to support like Rav Nachman. Shmini Regel Bifnei Atzmo Le'inyin Pazer Kashev. It's a abbreviation for six different things. Pei Zayin Reish Kuf Shin Beis. Pious Bifnei Atzmo, that when they did a lottery to which coin would do it, Shmini Atzeres gets its own lottery. Zion is Zman, Shechianu. Reish is Regel Bifnei Atzmo, that you don't sit in the sukkah. Kuf is Korban Bifnei Atzmo, because it has a different Korban than the other days of sukkahs. Shir Bifnei Atzmo, it has its own Shir. Bracha Bifnei Atzmo, that means we mentioned Shmini Chag Atzeres Hazeh, like we said, in benching and in Shmona Esrei. Okay, so tomorrow, 8 o'clock, and Mario, I'm not going to sign up because Saul's here, and I see Yaakov Yellen's already on. Why don't we
continue? Okay, I'll stop the recording and restart.
Okay, very good.
Okay, very good.